What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome to a brand new Football Talk video, and I will also preview the Newcastle United-Liverpool game, but today's main topic is can Liverpool win the Premier League title under Jurgen Klopp? Not necessarily this season, but in the next 3 years. Also, leave a prediction right now, who will finish in the top 6 in the Premier League and in what order? My order at the moment, based on the so far the season that has gone by, Man City, I think will win the league. Arsenal will finish second. I think Liverpool can make it to third place. I know this might be controversial, but I think we can get third, and Man United or Tottenham will finish fourth. I'm still undecided because, you know, Man United are not playing well, but they are picking up results. And let me know, guys. Do you know any other club where a manager came in and did such a remarkable turnaround and had such an amazing effect on the whole team, on the whole squad, and especially the playing style, the performances and the results, as Jurgen Klopp did at Liverpool? In his first 6 weeks, he completely transformed this team. And when I uploaded the video where I wanted Rodgers sacked, I said to you guys, before even Jurgen Klopp was on the radar, that this Liverpool squad is a pretty decent squad and we should be getting better results and we should be challenging for the top four with this squad. And I was convinced that with a better manager we could improve massively, and lo and behold, we just did. Rodgers only got 3 victories this season, and 2 of those were at home against Bournemouth and Aston Villa, and we couldn't even beat Carlisle United or the likes of Sion or Norwich City. We lost to West Ham at home. We couldn't even beat Bordeaux away from home. And Jurgen Klopp comes in and he had a pretty difficult start with the loads of injuries, and you know, the whole squad was low on confidence, but now they are absolutely flying. I mean, the performance at Man City, at Chelsea, at Southampton, honestly, since the title challenging season 2 years ago, I haven't been this excited as a Liverpool fan, and I'm sure if you are a Liverpool fan, you must be absolutely buzzing. Can we win the title this season? I think we are still short in terms of our defense. We only have 2 fit centre-backs at the moment, Lovren and Skrtel. And also, we don't have backups for Klein and Moreno. I mean, Render and Smith are very, very young players. If either Klein or Moreno gets injured, we are in huge trouble. So we need a bigger squad to seriously challenge for the title. But I mean, if we can play like we did at Southampton or at Man City, we can match any team in the Premier League. And why I'm so excited, because the Premier League is so unpredictable. All the top teams are dropping points. For example, Arsenal are in huge injury crisis and they dropped 5 points against West Brom and Norwich City, and honestly I didn't expect them to lose to West Brom. And their injuries are mounting up. Man City have huge injury problems as well. Aguero, David Silva, Yaya Toure, lots of other players injured. And basically anybody can beat anybody in this league. It just shows how unpredictable and how awesome the Premier League is. And if Jurgen Klopp can keep this squad fit and consistently performing like they are doing, I mean, we won 7 out of the last 8 games. And under Rodgers, we only won 3 games in the first like 12 games or something like that. And Jurgen Klopp won 7 in 11. That's a remarkable record. And we have Newcastle, West Brom, Watford, Leicester City, Sunderland, West Ham, Stoke. Teams that Liverpool can beat. I mean, if we can beat Man City at their ground, if we can absolutely destroys Southampton at their ground, we can beat any team on this form. I just really hope that Sturridge stays fit, because if Sturridge stays fit, we are seriously a top 4 team. We look like a top 4 team with Sturridge in the side and with a solid midfield. And I'm so excited for the future. I mean, Jurgen Klopp hasn't signed anyone. He came in the middle of the season. He had no preseason, no preparation time. He was playing games every 3 days. So he didn't have a lot of time to work with the players on the training ground. And he did this with Liverpool. Imagine what he can do when he will have 100 million to spend maybe next summer. Imagine what he can do with a full preseason. Imagine what Jurgen Klopp can do at Liverpool when he has his own players. The future is so bright on this man, and he just... I've never been this excited as a Liverpool fan, honestly. Even under Rafa Benitez, when we were challenging for Champions League trophies, getting to Champions League finals, we didn't play the most exciting football. Now we are playing very exciting football and we are getting results as well. And that's the perfect combination. We have so many young players. This team has a lot of potential. So let me know what do you think about this in the comments below. Where will Liverpool finish at the end of the season? And Newcastle United has to be shitting their pants, because Newcastle have the joint worst defense in the Premier League alongside Bournemouth. They conceded something like 30 goals or something like that. At Liverpool, they scored... Sorry. Excuse me. Liverpool scored 14 goals in the last 4 away games. We scored 13 goals away at Chelsea, Man City and Southampton combined. And before Jurgen Klopp took over, there was only one game where Liverpool scored more than one goal, and that was the only game where Sturridge started, Aston Villa at home, where we scored 2 goals. All in the other games under Rodgers this season, we only scored either 1 goal or 0. And under Jurgen Klopp, finally the goals are flying in, especially away from home. So I'm pretty confident that we can beat Newcastle United if nothing disastrous happens in our defending, because in attack we are brilliant at the moment. I really hope that Sturridge starts with Firmino behind him and Coutinho when he gets back fit. That's a mouth-watering attack. Let me know what do you think about this in the comments below, and thanks for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed this. See you later, guys. Have a lovely day. Goodbye.